What's going down, baby? You are now tuned into the Way Back When podcast, a reflection upon the golden era, our golden era. It's a new year, same me, because I'm perfect, in the wise words of that girl, Amanda Bynes. You already know who it is, the nostalgic one, you know what I'm saying, Mr. Golden Era himself, that boy Dizzle Stacks, you know what I'm saying? I'm coming with the other golden one, you know what I'm saying, with the Way Back News, keeping it fresh, keeping it clean, like one Andre Three Stacks and one Big Boy. Boy, you already know who he is.
Money B. What's up, dog?
What's going down, Wodies? We're in the year 2021. First episode of the year. You know what I'm saying? Back at y'all after a brief hiatus, a brief vacation and everything. You know what I'm saying? But we're oh so glad to be back. It's already been an eventful evening just getting this shit started up and everything right here. We almost didn't have an episode tonight. Almost didn't record an episode tonight, let me say that, because I thought I was gonna have to bury my dog. I thought I was gonna have to bury my boy Melville, dog.
You should have put him in like pet cemetery.
Yeah, I thought that's where I was headed, bro. I thought that's where I was headed. So as I clicked record on this Zoom meeting and everything, my dog started like spazzing out. I could hear him coughing, right? Yeah. I could hear him coughing. And then I heard him like trying to like he was like choking, like trying to cough up something. And then he was like chewing on the left side of his face or whatever, on the left side of his mouth.
Yeah.
Excuse me. And so I was like, okay, he's got something. So, you know, I ran over to him and I opened up his mouth, and you already know how that is. That's like, you know what I'm saying? Daniel in the lion's den, you know what I'm saying, trying to open up the jaws of the lion or whatever. That didn't actually happen in the Bible, but let's just pretend it did. But I swooped my finger down there, didn't feel nothing. And so my thinking was that, all right, he swallowed something, it got caught in his throat or something, because yeah. If you know my boy Melville, he's a destroyer, dog. If you seen my snap or my Instagram or whatever, like I bought him a little stuffed toy for Christmas and everything, a little stuffed snowman and shit, and he ripped that bitch apart the first day he got it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm thinking like he tried to eat all this stuffing and shit, and it didn't got, you know, lodged in his throat or some shit. You know what I'm saying? So I grab some peroxide, give him a shot of peroxide. Hopefully he throws it up or something. Nothing, dog, nothing. He's just dry heaving. He's foaming at the mouth and shit. And because he's like chewing on his left side, I'm thinking he's having a stroke, because now the left side of his jaw, like the left side of his head and everything, is literally like, it's getting lazy. You know what I'm saying? It's like drooping. And I'm like, what the fuck? And so now I'm getting ready. I'm calling animal hospitals and shit, yeah, and everything. And I get transferred over to another one. You know what I'm saying? Then they transfer me over to another one. I'm like, what fucking good are y'all? And meanwhile, my dog is dying, and he's like literally like chewing like an old person. You know how old people just chew for no reason sometimes? Yeah. So he's doing that. And so then finally I'm like, all right, let me try one more time. So I open those jaws back up and I swoop one more time and I find it. I get directly on that side, and it's like a little button that fell off of my office chair
that
he had been chewing on, and it got caught in the side of his mouth.
Yeah.
And I finally got that bitch out, and he was fine, and he started running around and shit. And so here we are.
I don't know if this applies to everybody, but have you had a dog die like in your lifetime, or your parents, or anybody?
Oh, no. I didn't have no pets growing up except for fish. My dad hates dogs.
Right.
Yeah. He can't stand dogs.
But that's an easy cleanup. Like I wanted to ask like, where do black people bury their dogs or do with their dogs? Cause we know somebody that has some land, or you can get to the river.
Okay. No. Okay.
We've never like buried a dog, you know.
Yeah, I can't answer that for you, dog. Yeah.
I'm glad we didn't have to find out tonight either.
Yeah, for sure. You know, shout out to my boy Melville. He's a trooper, dog. Shout out to my boy.
Well, see, at least he, like my dog, he just, Sexy Dex, he just runs off, dog. He just goes out into the night. You never know.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Never know. He's a little like me. You never know what
happens. He's a rolling stone, dog. He's a rolling stone.
Yeah, yeah. So, I don't know where he gets it from.
And Dexter was a rolling stone.
Yeah, he's a wild boy, man. He just, he sees that open, that freedom, and he's, boom, yeah, gone. Out of there. Out of there, dog. How was the holidays, man?
Holidays were very good. Holidays were very well. Let's get to you first, because we haven't heard from you in a while. You know what I'm saying? I know you and partook in some festivities at one point. Holler at us. Tell us how was San Antonio and all that, man.
Oh, San Antonio was great, dude. It was much needed. Played some golf.
There you go.
Getting the rounds in.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of liquid crack.
Yes.
Many of liquid cracks. And went to see the fight. And the fight was fucking badass. That boy Pina was with us.
I went to the Canelo fight, right?
The Canelo fight, yeah. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, I took my pops for his, that was his Christmas gift.
That's what's up.
So me and Pina's gift to him was like, take him for the weekend and have a fucking badass time at the fight. Pay for all the beer, food, all that good shit. We don't know what to get him anymore, man. We didn't buy him shit, fucking.
That's a badass gift, dog. That's raw as fuck.
Yeah. I talked to him. He's like, that's probably the best gift he's ever had. So.
I wish that I had four siblings to split like a gift like that.
We'll see. Nah.
I know where it's going.
But I mean, it was all fucking good. I mean, it's still badass. It was fucking fun, and then I tried to make it back that Sunday was the longest drive ever. But I made it, and I just had a lot of shit going on. So shout out to that boy Dub for filling in.
Hell yeah, shout out to Dub.
Mm-hmm. I know you wanted to get one more in, and I just couldn't do it, man. I had a lot of shit to get done. Yeah. So that happened. Drink for 4 days straight. Hard.
Yeah. I mean, it's a job. It's a job.
It is.
It's a job. And one of us has got to do it, if not both of us. I was just off that weekend.
Yeah. I was too, but I was off. that was a good time. And then, Christmas the following week. So it was a lot of fun, man. A lot of beer drinking, a lot of eating.
Hell yeah.
Now it's New Year's. And then, actually, you know what? I haven't seen a lot of the whole New Year, New Me shit.
Yeah.
I don't know about you. I haven't.
I haven't seen it at all, because I think that people are still too afraid of 2020.
Yep.
So they're like, because a lot of those New Year, New Me's came out in 2020 because it was like a new decade. What I'm saying? You got a new number and everything. Yep. All the holidays were like lined up on weekends. So everybody's excited as fuck for 2020. Oh, okay. It's like New Year, New Decade, New Me. You know what I'm saying? Yep. And
same old raggedy you.
Yeah, exactly. Egg fucking exactly.
No resolutions. I don't believe in resolutions and none of that shit. I mean, I just, same shit. I mean, just keep the circle smaller than the fucking caterpillar's booty hole. That's about it.
Good shit. I fucking love it. I love it, dog. For me, man, it was, everything is all good, man. I don't have too big of a family and everything. So I guess the one thing that sucked is like the holidays is always a time where, me and my small family, we are able to get together. Yeah. And we weren't able to do it this year and everything, of course, for obvious reasons and stuff. So that kind of sucked. But I still got to spend it with my immediate family, the peeps, my sister, my daughter and shit. So that was cool. I got my mom, speaking of like best Christmas presents ever. I bought my mom a wine fridge.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, so she was like so excited about that. Like, I just left their house a little while ago, and like she was pouring herself up a glass of wine and like just giggling to herself. She's like, ooh, the perfect temperature. Like, just cheesing, dog. So she's like in love with that gift. So Yeah. Shout out to Mom Dukes, you know what I'm saying? Had to do it big for her one time, you know. So that was all good. And then New Year's, man, shit, dog, just I didn't really do much, man. Just kicked it, and then New Year's Day ate some good old soul food. You know what I'm saying? Got them chitlins in my system. You know what I'm saying? Ate got two big spoonfuls of black eyed peas. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I need that extra good luck. You know what I'm saying, for 2021. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I don't know. Like, are you familiar with that? Like, tradition, I guess.
The black eyed peas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. What was that?
I've never partaken in it, but I've heard of it.
Okay. Well, so for those of you who don't know, like, for black people, like, our good luck tradition is like on New Year's, you got to eat black eyed peas. You know what I'm saying? You eat your good help in the black eyed peas on New Year's and you'll have good luck that year. So, you know, I doubled down and ate extra of them things. Now, we talked about this. Shout out to REC. You know what I'm saying? Y'all remember her from the show. I saw like one of her snaps or whatever, and they were like eating grapes. She was like, eat those grapes, or, you know, like getting on her people about eating the grapes as they counted down the new year and everything. And I was like, I've never heard that before in my life, like eating grapes for, I guess it's for good luck, or what were you saying? It's like to travel or something?
Dude, I don't know. Like, I never heard of it. I know it's 12 grapes. That's all I know. So I'm assuming one for each month, but I don't know. I've never heard of it. But my daughter was telling me that you eat them for like good travel or some weird shit like that.
Yeah. So I was talking to her about it. She was like telling me about it. And, you know, she said it's a Mexican thing, like a Mexican tradition.
Well, I guess I'm not Mexican enough.
I guess you're not. But that got me to thinking. It's like I feel like we should start like a new New Year's tradition for like good luck.
Let's do it.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. Maybe we have to come up with something. I mean, off top, I was thinking maybe Toppy. Like, maybe get some Toppy for the top of the year, for good luck for the rest of the year. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, everybody loves some good Toppy. You know what I'm saying? Toppy at the top of the year, it goes together. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. A little Toppy on New Year's Day, start your year off right.
After all the New Year's Eve festivities, you never know. It probably does happen anyway.
That's what I'm saying. What I'm saying. As a matter of fact, you got to like join them together. You know what I'm saying? You got to join them together. So it's like Toppy at the top of the year, and then on the back end of the year, a little bottom. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? A little doggy style. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I think I'm gonna start that tradition up this year.
That sounds good. Wow. Good luck with that. The ultimate would be the fucking like finish it right at fucking 12. Like right at the if you do that, you got skills, dog. You gotta fucking
plan it
a minute before.
Yeah, there you go. That's when you start letting them daddy strokes loose.
About 12:58.
Yeah. 12:58. Yeah, 12:59 in 20 seconds in. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Start letting them daddy strokes loose. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we'll time it out. We gotta figure out something, dude. And then you eat like, I don't know, fucking something, dude. 12 somethings. You gotta eat 12 somethings.
Yeah. Hell yeah. I like it. We'll work with it. We'll figure something out. You know what I'm saying? We'll figure something out. But good shit, man. Glad to see you for the new year and everything.
Oh, let's not forget about our golf. Our battle. I let this go humbly that day. I let this go humbly.
Here we go.
So the recap, it was you and Peanut. Two former athletes, as Peanut put it, you know, against me and Jeeves, two very active older alcoholics. And we came out victorious. Came out victorious, so we got bragging rights for the year.
Bragging rights for the year. Kudos to y'all too. You know,
nice gentleman's game.
Good. It was a good gentleman's game. For those of y'all who don't know, Peanut has been golfing for some years now. Mr. Jeeves has been golfing for some years now.
Yeah, he's on the senior circuit.
But myself and Money B, like, we're beginners. I think we mentioned it in one of the past episodes. So we just started. So it was like, all right, you know, perfect even matchup. You know what I'm saying? So two who are familiar with the game, two who aren't familiar, you know. And so I think it was both of ours. I think it was maybe what, your third time playing and my second time playing?
Third time, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And so yeah, we had a good gentleman's game of golf, you know what I'm saying? That boy, excuse me, that boy, the legend of Swagger Vance, was out there, you know what I'm saying? Swagged out to the maximum, to the fullest. That's one thing. I mean, we lost, but I look good as fuck. I look good as hell. You know what I'm saying? Good. That boy is swagged to the T, you know what I'm saying? They couldn't hate on the kid. So yeah, man, I all right. Quick shout out to y'all. Y'all did y'all's thing. You know what I'm saying? Y'all did y'all's thing. I'm not going to hate on it. It is what it is.
And it'll probably be another year before I get to play again.
Nah, fuck that. We're playing when I go down there to Houston later this month.
Oh, yeah. Well, shit.
Let's do it, dog.
I mean, you know.
I got that itch now, baby. I got that itch.
It is. Like, for real. No shit. Like, the other day, whenever Peanut sent me a snap, he was playing, I was like, fucking bitch.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, yeah, you come up fucking, I mean, Money B stays in a, you know, golf course community. So,
yes.
Yeah, it's right down the road, dog.
Yeah. Because, see, that's literally like the first competitive thing that I've done, really, like myself, since like college baseball. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you know, I used to coach and I was competitive in that, but like, you know what I'm saying? You're coaching through kids. Yeah, no, the kids are doing all the work for you. You know what I'm saying? But like, this is like the first time, like, those got those juices flowing. You know what I'm saying? I know y'all can see it in my, I had that eye of the I can't say the eye of the tiger, 'cause we lost and I was trash. I had the eye of the, I don't know. Alley cat. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Alley cat came out the gutter.
Yeah, I had that eye to alley cat real quick. You know what I'm saying? I was ready. You know what I'm saying? When we got to that back nine.
Yeah, but the guy with cataracts, it's got like gloss over it.
She got it scratched out in a street fight.
Yeah, it's like scratched out. It's got a little bit of like that little crust on there.
Yeah.
His eyelashes are kind of stuck together, like he got a peak eye, but he's all right. He's good.
hell yeah. But yeah, I'll be ready for the next go around.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, hell yeah. All right, good shit, man. Good shit. You know what? One thing that we haven't had in a long ass time. Matter of fact,
herpes.
We speak for yourself, sir. Speak for yourself. You know, we hadn't had any of that god dang way back when news all fucking year, Money B.
All fucking year long, dude.
That's my dad joke. That's my dad joke of the episode.
There you go. All right, man. I got you.
And now, way back when news with Money B.
I gotta take it back to a couple from the end of the year, just because they were so big.
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's start with the birthdays. December 29th, happy birthday to the great Pimp C.
Yes, sir, Pimp Chad.
Had to go back and bring that one up, man. It was badass that day up here in Houston, because on the box, they were fucking jamming like all fucking day long, dude. I hardly ever listen to the regular radio.
Yeah.
But it's always the same three songs.
Yeah.
But yeah, that from the morning to night, afternoon, everything, they were jamming fucking, you know, UGK, Pimp C, everything. It was badass.
Hell yeah.
So, yeah. Happy birthday to that boy. This one, I had to bring this one up too, which I thought was pretty cool. December 31st, happy birthday to Brent Berry. Do you remember that boy?
Yeah, I do. I do remember Brent Barry.
Is he the last white dude to win the slam dunk contest? Is he the only white dude to win it? Aaron Gordon.
You might be right.
I don't know. I don't know what Zach LaVine is.
But I don't think Gordon hasn't won one.
Right, LaVine always robbed him, right? Or I mean, it was always badass.
He always got robbed by somebody. But I think Brent Barry might be the only white boy to win one of them hoes.
Yeah.
What if that was like a stat on ESPN? Like,
yeah,
that's what we got to bring back. We got to bring back ESMP stats. You know what I'm saying? White boys in history. Brent Barry, first white boy to win the NBA slam dunk contest post segregation.
Well, they probably won one before. It was a layup contest.
Yeah.
But he was fucking cold. And then it was like so badass because his dad was fucking cold. His brother, played. They were all fucking ballers. So
mm-hmm.
I had to bring that one up. He was a big deal back in the day. All right, let's go. January 1st. Happy birthday to Derek Thomas from the Chiefs, if you remember that boy.
Linebacker. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, he's that boy. He's a wild boy now, dog.
Yeah.
He's a wild boy, dog.
Yeah.
If you go follow him on Twitter, he is a trip. Somebody was talking. Oh, man. Somebody posted it today. Herschel Walker. They're like.
Another one.
He's the like spokesperson for CTE Records, like the CEO of CTE Records. Somebody tweeted that and I fucking died. But you could put what you call it. You put Derek Johnson. If Herschel Walker is the CEO, you know what I'm saying? What you call it? Derek Johnson's the damn manager of.
Derek Thomas, fool.
Derek Thomas, excuse me.
No, Derek Thomas died.
Yeah, Derek Thomas died. Oh, I got him confused. Both played for the Chiefs, though.
Derek Thomas died. Yeah. But anyway, he was.
They both played for the Chiefs.
They both played. Yeah. Derek Johnson was the running back.
Yeah. That's right.
Either way, yeah, he's fucking wild as shit.
Yeah. But he was fucking good, man.
Mm-hmm.
He was so damn good.
Yeah, he was real good. I don't know what happened. He only played for the Chiefs, right?
I believe so. Yeah, man, we'll have to look that up one day and maybe discuss it, you know what I'm saying, for some way back whenness, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so. I got you. All right, same day, January 1st, happy birthday to Morris Chestnut. He's been in a lot of fucking badass movies back in our day.
I didn't realize Morris Chestnut was like 50. Yeah. And I was like, damn, dog, like we're getting old if Morris Chestnut is 50. You know what I'm saying?
I'm pretty sure he still looks the same, huh?
What was that?
He still looks the same.
Oh, come on, baby. You know that black don't crack. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know that black don't crack.
Yeah, he's
I ain't even seen him, but I'm just saying, you know that black don't crack.
I just figured, I don't know. I mean, it takes a while, then all of a sudden it just takes it downhill. It's like, I don't want to get racist on this. It's kind of like Asian people. Asian people, you don't fucking know. It's always one day to the next, dog. Either way.
Happy birthday, Morris Chestnut. Dog. He was
fucking Ricky. He was in what is it?
Oh yeah.
We
talked about him a couple episodes with that boy Rainey. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Two could play that game. Deliver Us from Eva.
Yeah.
No, I mean not Deliver Us from Eva. Fuck, what was it? God dang it. What was I thinking of? I don't fucking know. Anyways, he's been. Yeah, oh, I forgot. Yeah, you were a little twisted.
I haven't been like I say on the podcast in about 3 to 4 weeks.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've been on it, but I wasn't in it. You know what I'm saying? All right, let's keep it moving. Same day, happy birthday to Vern Troyer.
Shit. Yeah,
fucking Austin Powers. He died not too long ago too.
Yeah,
I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. Last one, January 1st. Happy birthday, Fernando Tatis, not Junior.
Oh yeah. Fernando Tatis was raw as hell. Because he was like 5'5 and just hitting tanks. You know that boy was roided up, dog.
Oh, yeah, dude. He was in the middle of all that shit, too, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Without being in the middle of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But he was still raw no matter what, dog.
And son now is fucking hitting bombs.
His son is a baller, dog.
Yeah.
Oh, he's real. Yeah. He's the real deal. Like he's the new face of the league, dog. Like, mm-hmm. He's real, dog.
Yeah, he's one of them for sure. All right, January 2nd, happy birthday, Edgar Martinez. Another fucking baller.
Yep.
Happy birthday to Sweet Pea Pernell Whitaker.
Pernell Whitaker, yep.
Yeah, that boy used to be cold, man. He's like watching him fight. Did you watch the fight last night?
I did not, no. No, man, I don't... Man, it has to be like a huge boxing match for me to like get invested now. You know what I'm saying? I understand like boxing most definitely is making somewhat of a comeback because there's a lot of young stars and everything. The Garcia kid, and understand, just to give a little history about me, like boxing, I was a real big boxing fan when I was younger. But you know, like with a lot of people, it lost its essence, you know what I'm saying, as we got older and everything. But now it's starting to make a little bit of a comeback. The Garcia kid, you know, I'd been hearing about him, but I was waiting for him to fight somebody like more well known, you know what I'm saying? Like that's what I'm waiting on for him. And so
his next one will be that. His next one will be
with Davis. That's the one. That's the rumored one with Gervonta Davis.
That fucking happens. I don't know, because this dude that he fought was like a grizzled vet, dog. Like he was a gold medalist and had only lost like the best of the best. So
he
was
knocked him down too, right?
Oh, he caught him down.
Yeah, he caught him in like the second round. They said
if Tank catches him like that, fuck, he ain't getting
up. Night. Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, either way, it was good. I tuned in to fucking see. I had never seen him fight. You know, I was just seeing fucking shadow boxing on Instagram and shit. And he's gonna be like the next, and then like he's gonna be like the next Mexican fucking superstar.
Yeah.
But he's got, I mean, fuck, he looks good. He's fucking young on fucking, you know, social media with fucking those Paul boys.
Yeah.
Like, he's huge if he keeps winning.
Yeah. So yeah, I mean, I'm definitely like interested. But I'm not buying a fight unless it's like two well-known names. You know what I'm saying? I'm not that invested into boxing yet where it's like I want to just watch. Like when Mayweather was fighting, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you never heard of Ricky Patton. Or excuse me, not Ricky Patton, Ricky Hatton.
Yeah.
You never heard of Ricky Hatton, but you were still buying that fight because it was Mayweather. You know what I'm saying? The only other one I could say that you would have been doing that now is with what's the heavyweight that just got? How am I forgetting his name?
Oh, Fury or Joshua?
No, the one who lost.
Wilder.
There we go. Well, Wilder. That's the only one you're like literally might buy a fight for if he was fighting somebody, you know, lesser known.
Just Randy. Yeah.
Just because you wanted to see somebody get knocked out. Basically, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So yeah, but there's a lot of good young fighters out right now. I watched the last. Did you watch the last Lemonchenko fight when he lost?
When he lost, yeah.
Lopez. Teoflo.
Shit like that, yeah.
Yeah. That was a good. I mean, he beat his ass. He beat Lemonchenko's ass.
There was a good fight on the undercard last night. Some younger, no, not younger, but they're lightweights, dude. That was a badass fight, man. I mean. They're just slugging it out, but yeah, it was cool. I had to just fucking check it out, just see what the hype was about. And I mean, shit, it was a good fight.
That's what's up, man. I'm like I said, I'm not like into it, but I'm excited. You know what I'm saying? I'm excited to see where it's going. You know what I'm saying? Because I think
unless it was something to watch. It was shit out yesterday. I mean, I watched some college football, but other than that,
yeah.
All right, let's keep it moving. A couple more birthdays. Same day, January 2nd, happy birthday, Paz Vega. You know who that is?
Why does that name sound familiar?
Let me tell you the movie she was in. Most notably that we would know would be Nacho Libre.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
She was in Southbound and Down, right? Or Eastbound and Down?
Yeah, she was. She was. I forgot about that.
Yeah, she was.
She is Encarnacion.
Yeah.
When the fantasy has ended and all the children are gone, something good inside me helps me to carry on. I ate some books, I ate some grass, I used my hand to wipe my tears, to kiss your mouth, I break my vows. No, 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 with Jose, unless you want to, then we break our vows together. Encarnacion, 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 Encarnacion.
Hell yeah, that one good.
We gotta, we definitely gotta go over Nacho Libre one episode.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely, dude.
But yeah, she's a baddie in a bunch of other movies too. But yeah, one time we would know that it's that one.
Shout out to Paz Vega.
Yeah, related. Last birthday, January 2nd. Happy birthday to Taye Diggs. Another one that was in a bunch of fucking movies, you know.
Holler back, player.
Yeah,
remember he said that shit in Malibu's Most Wanted.
Yeah,
nah, he cracked me up in that movie. Shout out to Taye Diggs, dog. He's a, I fuck with Taye Diggs, man.
Hell yeah. It was always with him. It was him, Morris Chestnut, fucking yep. Omar Epps.
Yep.
And the other, there's another one.
And the black classics, man.
Back yeah.
Yeah, dog.
Good hell shit. Yeah.
I fuck with Taye Diggs.
Let's go. January 3rd, happy birthday, and fuck you to Eli Manning.
Dude, you just said that was the last one.
Oh, for that day, for that day.
Oh, shit. All right, yeah, let's run through these motherfuckers. Then.
Yeah,
I don't give a fuck about Eli Manning. Fuck Eli Manning, dude.
Yeah, fuck Eli Manning. January 3rd, happy birthday to Mel Gibson. He's in a bunch of fucking classics.
Fuck Mel Gibson, too.
And he's a racist, though.
Yeah, fuck Mel Gibson, too.
All right. All right, last birthday, January 3rd. Happy birthday to the great fucking Jim Ross.
Hell yeah. Shout out to Jim Ross.
The someone, son of Sean Stocks.
Someone, by the way he talks, you might think he was racist, but I don't think he's racist. At least we have no evidence. So shout out to Jim Ross. By God, that Stone Cold Steve Austin's music. That son of a bitch.
The funniest shit. Is Jim Ross commentating over anything?
Like, yeah,
I think it was on Twitter. It was commentating over Mario Kart or fucking just anything, a cooking show. But the funniest one I've ever seen, and I can't find it. It was on a sports show. I was flying back from fucking Vegas after a weekend, right? And there was some. It was been a few years back. There was a sports show on Fox Sports called like Jay and Dave or some shit.
Okay,
they had Jim Ross commentating over the Home Run Derby.
Oh,
dude,
shit.
It was the best shit ever. And I could not fucking find it for anything, dude. It was that's the funniest shit ever. Or I was still very drunk from the weekend. But yeah, happy birthday to Jim Ross, the best commentator. I wonder if he talks like that at home, dude. We should pocket that for a skit. We'll talk about that later. Because I have an idea. Now,
it's the wheels are turning, dog. And I ain't even said nothing, and I'm laughing my
ass. We'll save it for later. We'll talk about this tomorrow.
I'm literally writing this down right now. Fuck that.
Hell yeah. All right, we got a couple.
No, I gotta let this fly. I gotta let this fly real quick. What if off of Jim Ross, but we just got to talking about Michael Buffer. I mean, we just got to talk about boxing. Michael Buffer, he's about to make a sexy thing with his wife. Let's get ready to rumble. I had to let it fly. I had to let that one fly.
Like, for real, what if they talk like that? All the announcers, all like, the okay, I, the boxing announcer last night, he had a lazy eye. He had a little bit of a lazy eye. He looked a little thrown off, right? But his voice was so fucking smooth, dude. Like,
oh yeah,
it just didn't go with him.
Yeah,
but like, I just imagine, like, what if they go like to the drive thru? What if they pull up to the drive thru and they talk like that or some shit? You know?
Yeah. All right, let's keep it moving.
All right, let's go. All right, January 3rd, 1996. The first, and this is what they called it, the first clamshell flip phone went on sale. It was the Motorola Star Trek, but they call it a clamshell flip phone. I've never heard of it called that. But anyway, the first flip phones went on sale January 3rd, 1996.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about, I thought there was like a different type of flip phone that was like shaped like a clam or some shit.
Yeah, like some fucking Flintstone shit.
Yeah. But the first flip phone was invented in 1996, you said?
January 3rd, 96 is when it went on sale. They sold 60 million, and I bet the is fucking way better than the fucking iPhone still.
Yeah, dog. The biggest flex for like having a flip phone was like hanging up on somebody.
Yeah,
just, you know what I'm saying? Like, you just cuss somebody out, or they just said something out of the side of their neck or whatever. You was like, nigga, and then just slap that bitch clothes on them.
Hell yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's all they heard was that clap. You know what I'm saying?
Biggest flex, dog. Oh yeah, that was I might have had one flip phone, maybe.
Well, see, you know, I talk about my pops, my peeps and shit a lot on here. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, they never bought me Jordans. I didn't get a PlayStation I didn't get like a gaming system until the PlayStation came out. Yeah. And so when it came to phones, like, I mean, now it's normal for a fucking third grader to have a phone.
Yeah, no, you know
what I'm saying? But back then, like when phones were just like cellular phones were just becoming, you know, really, really popular and stuff.
Like
a lot of my friends had phones like in seventh and eighth grade, you know what I'm saying? And those are the old school brick Nokias, you know what I'm saying, that you played Snake on and shit. I didn't get a phone till like the 10th grade, and I had to get a flip phone because like flip phones were old.
That was probably the free one.
Yeah. Because he bought his new phone and they were like, well, yeah, you buy a phone and you get one free. You know what I'm saying? and so like flip phones were like old by the time I got one. My first phone was a flip phone and everything. But shout out to the old phones. I miss them bitches sometimes, you know what I'm saying?
Because
life was simplified and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just called people, texted people. And, you know, played some games on there. And that was about
it. That is it. That is fucking it, dude. All right. This was good. This is pretty cool one. January 3rd, 2001. The Dave Matthews Band becomes the first major artist to release. They released a song on Napster.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I never knew that shit. Because we were always just streaming whatever the fuck we wanted. You know, burning CDs. I never knew that somebody actually released their shit straight to Napster.
Yeah. How do you think that the creator of Napster feels now that like everything is on, like everything is streaming? You know what I'm saying?
We should probably. I bet he's got some money. Yeah, he's probably been loaded since then. You know?
You think so?
I think so, dude. I mean, he feels smart enough to figure that shit out.
Well, because. Yeah, I guess you're right about that. But I was just thinking, like, because he had that whole thing with Metallica and everything and getting sued. And then I can't actually remember, like, what was the results of that? Like, didn't he have to come up off some bread? Like, didn't he lose?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he lost. I just don't know how much. I bet it was a grip for something like that. And I'm pretty sure that wasn't the only, like, band that fucking
did. Exactly. Yeah. So... I also feel like we've talked about this before too.
We've hit it up. I know we've hit up like LimeWire and shit like that, but I don't think we've really ever dug into it.
My deja vu just hit me about us talking about Napster, but But damn, I'm interested in that now. Like, I wonder what he's doing, because you're talking about like Steve Jobs money. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
With the impact that he had on the industry, like, he should be like Steve Jobs rich. You know what I'm saying?
Well, that's, yeah, he's got a net worth of about $3 billion. I think he's doing all right.
I no longer feel sorry for him. So
yeah,
fuck that guy. I am now right. Jealous.
Yeah, Wikipedia said. So I think he'll be all right. So either way, that was pretty. I never knew that. Like I said, they released straight, which I guess that's a pretty dope move. Kind of like, all right, fuck it, it's gonna go there anyway.
Right. Exactly.
Just beat it.
Exactly. But
I wonder how they capitalized off of it though.
Yeah, I mean, they probably worked something out, right? I mean,
you would think so. Yeah.
Yeah, they probably worked something out.
All right, cool. Oh, this one's pretty dope. January 3rd, 2008. Britney Spears suffers a mental breakdown in Beverly Hills. So, y'all, everybody remembers that shit.
Shout out to my boo, Britney. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, that's when she shaved her head and did all the crazy shit, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, that's when you first... I don't know, man. I won't say you first, but that's when, I guess, my generation first realized, like, oh, like, celebrities be going crazy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, these motherfuckers be going through it, and it was like the paparazzi age, like when paparazzi first started like popping up on people.
Yeah,
you know. So yeah, that shit was wild, and you're like, yo, Britney needs help. You kind of feel sorry for her and shit.
Yeah. Yeah, but she's tripping now too, though, right?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, ever since then, she's been gone, bro. She's been gone. Like, I do feel sorry for her, because it's like, she's been gone, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. She just seemed like...
Nobody's gonna tell her no. Everybody's just gonna try to, like, you know, just get...
Exactly. And then you, like, listen to, like, her older songs. Like, her first song, like, Hit Me Baby One More Time, like... I want to say she was like 16 or 17 when that shit came out. And like, that shit is about getting smashed on. You know what I'm saying? Like, my loneliness is killing me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I've heard it. I've never really like paid attention to it.
Well, we haven't dug deep into it here on the Way Back When podcast, but Dizzle Stacks was an avid Britney Spears fan as a young lad.
Yeah, it's been rumored.
Yeah, rumors out that Dizzle Stacks was a young Britney Spears stan back in the gap. It was the schoolgirl's outfit, dog. It was the schoolgirl uniform, dog. It did it for me, okay? I'm breaking. I can't help it. I can't keep it in any longer. I can't keep it in any longer.
That gets people every time, dog.
Yeah, man. I mean, shout out to Britney Spears. I mean, sucks to suck, but that's something I would say to somebody I don't feel sorry for, but I kind of feel sorry for Britney Spears.
Yeah.
Anyways, let's keep moving.
All right. Oh shit. January 2nd, 1999. Chocolate Salty Balls from the TV series South Park hits number one in the UK.
I forgot all about that.
Oh, dude. Yeah.
Dog, you are nailing it with the news this week, dog. You are starting out you are starting out 2021 strong as fuck, dog.
I'm back and fresh. Like, I feel like it's like if I'm fresh from rehab, dude.
Yes.
All I drink right now.
Oh shit. I forgot all about that shit, dog. Oh my gosh. Oh, yeah, that shit was hilarious, bro.
Fucking hilarious. If y'all haven't seen that shit, it's Chef singing like a love song, isn't it?
Isaac Hayes, yeah.
Isaac Hayes, there you go. I was thinking him or Barry White.
They both got deep voices, so I mean, yeah. I feel it.
But dude, that shit was fucking hilarious. I can't believe that shit even like fucking still plays on TV. You know, actually, I was at that resort last week, and there was, you know, they didn't have like Netflix or nothing, so I had to actually watch like cable.
Yeah, so you had to watch South Park.
Oh, South Park was on, dude. And yeah, it was like a Christmas episode, but it was like selling weed and like, dude, it was the funniest shit. I haven't seen that shit in forever. And it was fucking hilarious.
Oh yeah. Shout out to South Park.
Hell yeah.
Pushing boundaries, though.
That wouldn't be a bad idea to do a fucking episode on them. Just go through the craziest shit they've ever had.
Oh man, dude. They need multiple episodes. They need multiple. We'd have to do like one season. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. All right. Last event. This is fucking great for both of us. We talked about it before. January 1st, 2006. Flavor Flav's reality show, Flavor of Love, premiered.
Flavor Flav! Shout out to the
three seasons.
Boy, Flavor Flav, dog.
Hell yeah.
All right. Best reality show of all time. Easily.
One of them. All right, man. That's the news, except for... Oh, I got the law. Let me get this
okay
in.
Okay.
And this is for Texas, dog. I don't know if y'all know about this. It kind of makes sense, though. I'm just hoping they're... I'm assuming this is meant for animals.
Okay.
So, it is illegal to milk another person's cow. Now, I'm hoping they're talking about animals. That's all I'm saying. I don't know how many Wodies is out there milking cows, but never know how they could interpret that.
Every one of these come down to is like, how did this law formulate?
Yeah.
But I mean, I guess it makes sense. It makes this sense. It makes sense because back in the gap, when there wasn't much to eat, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Maybe Texas is going through a famine, you know what I'm saying? And niggas was jumping the fences and going and, you know, hitting them udders, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I've never milked a cow before, so I don't know what udders sound like, but I'm just going to go with that. And they, you know what I'm saying? Boom, hop the fence with a pail of milk. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To go and feed to their family and everything. And then it's just like, oh, who goes there milking my cow? You know, milking my young steed.
I really don't think it would have been that much talking. It would probably just been shooting.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. For sure.
More than likely.
But I mean, that it makes sense to me. You know what I'm saying? Maybe niggas is going through a famine. Niggas was stealing cow milk. You know what I'm saying? Or another idea just popped up. Or maybe you just had some freaky ass niggas out there that were just hopping their neighbor's fence and sucking on the neighbor's cow udders. You know what I'm saying? And the police, like, they was freaky deaky too. They was like, all right. You can suck on your own cow titties, you know what I'm saying? But don't just go over to somebody else's cow titties and suck on their cow titties. You suck on your own cow titties.
That's how shit's saying.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that was actually probably like the first... I think if you go back and match shit up, that was the first, like, the first coronavirus, like... Maybe the first vaccine that was needed is because motherfuckers is like sucking cow titties.
No,
cow
I think that shit started way before that.
But I that's why I said first vaccine. Oh, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Maybe.
Yeah. It's like the first vaccine was needed because niggas was sucking on cow udders. You know what I'm saying? Well, let me take, I'm using niggas as everybody right now, but let me take niggas out of there because I don't think niggas would be sucking on cow udders. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'll put that off on somebody else. You know what I'm saying? Wink, wink. Y'all know who we're talking about.
Yeah. But either way, like, and that's still enforced to this day. That's the thing about it. Like, all this shit I'm saying.
To this day. To this
day, though. To this day.
Well. So, I mean, valid.
You got boys out there listening to us, you know, get drunk out in the country sometimes. I know you got some people.
Stay away from your neighbor's cows.
Anybody's cows, if it ain't yours.
Yeah.
And that could be a lesson in life. you know, I mean, I don't know what you call your woman or whatever, but hey.
Young nigga preach.
But that's the news, though.
Good shit, good shit. Let me go get some ice real quick to re-up, you know what I'm saying? And then, yeah, we'll get back to it.
All right, while we take this break, check out what you missed previously on Chocolate Covered Frog Legs with Morgan and Everett.
What's up, people? It's Friday, and Fridays are for the frogs. Welcome to Chocolate Covered Frog Legs. I am EJ, along with my co-host, as always, the first lady of this bread baby gang shit, Morgan.
Fine. Like, we did a lot of white people shit, but it was cool. Like, I
see, white people shit sometimes can be cool.
Yeah,
sometimes
that's what I'm saying. Like,
okay, let me tell you something about my puma.
Okay.
Floyd Mayweather has tigers, two, an albino and a regular one.
Oh, okay, yeah. You're referring to the post that you made, and I said...
Yeah.
So, you posted a cougar and said you wanted it as a pet.
It was a puma.
Puma cougar. It's a big cat that can kill you. That's what I was like.
Not if you raise it right. Humans can kill, too, but if you raise them right...
Very true. Yeah.
It is a valid point.
It is.
Yeah. Cheers to me.
Okay. You earned that one, yeah.
Happy birthday to me.
But just stealing birthdays now. Jeez. Golly. Morgan is taking over the whole game.
Y'all make sure to check out Chocolate Covered Frog Legs with Morgan and Everett on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, all that good shit. Fridays are for the frogs. Bread Baby ENT. Now let's get back to the show.
Money B, thank you oh so very much for that way back when news. But you already know, Modis, it's time. It's been a while, you know what I'm saying? It's a new year, you know what I'm saying? Y'all ready for a new fix? You know what I'm saying? We're getting this party started off right. We're getting this year started off right and shit, you know. So I know y'all are itching for it, so we're just gonna go ahead and bring it to you, baby. We got that fix for you coming to you right now.
Ooh, we're gonna have a lot of fixes.
We're gonna have so many fucking fixes up in this motherfucker. No diggity, no doubt. I like to bang it up. This is fucking wonderful, Holmes.
All right, so we decided to kick off the new year a little bit different. You know what I'm saying? We have, you know, normally we attack a certain topic, you know what I'm saying, and go and do our research, our way back when research and everything, and come back to you. And we discuss that topic from the golden era, or, you know what I'm saying, we might, you know, freestyle off the top of the dome, you know what I'm saying, Mo City Don freestyle type shit, you know what I'm saying, and hit you with the Russian roulette questions and everything. But we decided to take it a little bit different and just get a little creative with it. You know what I'm saying? So we got two separate topics for this episode. And for the first one, we're going to save the best for last. Yeah, let's save the best for last. So for this first one, okay, we went and we thought back. Which athlete from way back when would we have loved to see play a different sport? Okay. Does that make sense? So, you know what I'm saying? You got your Bo Jacksons. You know what I'm saying? You got your Deion Sanders. You know what I'm saying? Which athlete would we have loved to see do something of that nature? Okay. And so that's the first thing we're coming with y'all with. On this episode, this 2021, first episode of 2021, Way Back When podcast. So Money B, holla at me, dog. What athlete from way back when would you want to see play a different sport from what they actually excelled in professionally? All
right. So obviously, I mean, people have seen the videos, but I mean, Iverson playing quarterback was pretty fucking dope, you know?
Yeah, Bubba Chuck. I actually just watched that shit last week, actually.
Yeah, that shit was fucking dope. So that got me to thinking. I was like, all right, so what about some of these dudes in that era, right? Basketball. Mm-hmm. What if Vince Carter was a fucking receiver?
Yes.
Yes. Sean Kemp. What if Sean Kemp, because Sean Kemp had a little bit more meat on him, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
As a fucking receiver. And then you got, like, I don't know, let's say, for instance, you got fucking...
And how tall was Sean Kemp, too?
He had to be like 6'6", 6'7".
Yeah. Oh, he would have been a problem.
Dude, think about that shit. And he was fast. Because, you know, you got some dudes that are, like, around that... I mean, well, you've seen them in person.
Sean Kemp was 6'10".
6'10"? Oh,
he was 6'10". He would have been a freak ass. He would have been Rob Gronkowski before Rob Gronkowski.
Yeah,
he would have
been faster, bro.
Yeah, he would. Oh my god, he would have been a problem. He'd have been a problem, bro. Nah, hell nah, dog. That shit would have been unfair.
So shit like that, dude. Like I get to think about shit like that. Like there's so fucking many. Like okay, so that got me to thinking. Just because of the way Gary Payton played defense, what if he was like a corner or a fucking safety?
Yep. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I could see corner written all over him, dog. Corner,
right? Exactly.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
That was the shit. And, I mean, the whole reason I thought about this, like, you know, we had talked about it, but I thought about this because they were showing Brock Lesnar, like, they were showing all these UFC highlights and shit, and they were showing Brock Lesnar whenever he went to the UFC. And I was like, dude, what if fucking Big Show went to the UFC? Or what if fucking... somebody like that, you know, fucking humongous played in the NFL. What if Big Show was like a lineman, though? Which, I mean, there's probably some linemen that size, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
I mean, you think about that. They've always talked about LeBron, like, I think he played receiver and shit.
Which, yeah, he was like an all-state receiver in high school and shit.
Yeah, fucking crazy, dude. Fuck, I don't know. What about, like... Fuck, let's say Ricky Henderson as a fucking running back.
Yeah.
Or a receiver. Or anything.
Just fat, or like a slot receiver or something. Yeah, he was just fast as hell, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, hell yeah. I fucking love that. Thinking about Sean Kemp as a receiver or a tight end is just, like, horrifying. Like,
I would say receiver. I don't think he's big enough to be tight end as far as, like, on the blocking and shit.
Man, I don't know, because if you think about it, like he could, it's not like he was lightweight. He could easily like transform himself in the sport, like, and put on a little bit more weight. Cause yeah, dog, I think he could have played tight end in the league and been a beast. 6'10" cause
what about White Chocolate as a quarterback? I mean, I know he was smaller.
Yeah.
Pigeon.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he was 6 foot, which is, I mean, yeah, that's like, hold on. Yeah, he was 6'1". You know what I'm saying? So that's a little short for a quarterback, but it's not too bad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I think Russell Wilson is 5'10".
Yeah.
5'10", 6 foot. And so, I mean, like, yeah, he definitely could have made it happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, that would have been raw as fuck to see as well.
I mean, see, like me, like, all right, so I think like Karl Malone's a fucking tight end,
yeah,
so that's why I say, like, I know, but I think like Sean Kemp was like the same fucking position size as him. He just seemed faster, though.
Well, he just seemed faster, but the thing is, is like he was just so freakishly more athletic than Karl Malone, like, he could jump out of the gym, and so
at that size, too,
yeah, that's what I'm saying, like. He wouldn't play wide receiver because, just frankly, like, he's too tall. You know what I'm saying? He's probably too tall and not fast enough. Like, cornerbacks could actually keep up. Yeah, right. You know what I'm saying?
Where's he taking it from? Just throw the hell up.
Yeah, but if they're blanking it, you know what I'm saying? I mean, he would literally – I mean, he could. But he would be more of a problem. He would be more of a problem at tight end. Like, he would
– True, yeah.
He would, oh my gosh, this is tripping me out now just thinking about it.
Well, it's kind of like the whole thing, Randy Moss playing basketball, like in high school or college.
Yeah, right? Yeah. Yeah, I mean, because, well, Randy Moss was a problem. Randy Moss is 6'8", you know what I'm saying? Right. Randy Moss is 6'8", and fast as hell.
Fast as hell.
So, just thinking about, like, you talk about matchup problems in football. Like, the best tight ends are always matchup problems for linebackers and defensive backs because they're too fast for linebackers and they're too big for the defensive backs and everything.
Yeah.
And athletic You know what I'm saying? The athletic tight ends are always the best. The ones that can catch, ones that have good hands and everything. Like, if you just put some hands on Sean Kemp, it's over with. He's best tight end ever.
Yeah. How do you know he don't have hands, though? That motherfucker's hands are probably humongous.
We don't. I'm just saying. Yeah,
you can palm a fucking basketball, a fucking football.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. He would be the best tight end ever.
Yeah.
Hands down.
See, there you go.
Hands down. Best tight end.
Shit ever. Like that. So another one I was thinking about was like just the ferocity of Mike Tyson. You see him as a linebacker or some shit, right? Mm-hmm. I know he's smaller, but if he put that fucking force that he put into his punches. Oh, what if he was a pitcher? He fucking had all that velocity and torque in his fucking punches. I don't really know how it would translate to fucking pitching, but.
Well, I mean, athletes are athletes. You know what I'm saying? The great thing. shout out to Tony Jr.
I put my kids on game.
I saw that. Shout out to 50 Tyson too. What I was gonna say is the great thing about baseball is you can you can get away with not being an athlete but being just a top tier pitcher. You know what I'm saying? Like,
shout out to Peanut.
I'm not letting you throw shots at my boy just because we lost. Fuck that. it's funny because like my college coach or whatever, like he used to call us like the position players, like the position players, and then he called the pitchers like the non-athletes or whatever. Because you could like go pull this string bean, you know what I'm saying? Dude that looks like he's never lifted a weight in his life or whatever, you know what I'm saying? And he'd get up on the mound and throw, 90. You know what I'm saying? It's like, what the hell? How is that coming out of this body or whatever? And that's the beauty of pitching and beauty of baseball. Yeah. But on the other hand, it does help to be a fucking athlete.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's literally what the game has turned into. Like, if you watch a lot of baseball now, like a majority of the pitchers now are actual, like, athletes. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
They're athletes. Man, he was showing pictures of fucking Chapman.
So I could definitely see Iron Mike on the bump, you know what I'm saying? 5'10", 6 foot, just pumping ched, you know what I'm saying? Pumping ched by people, you know?
I think that's too, I think he needs more violence.
But see, that's the thing. When you're the pitcher, it's all in your hands. You know what I'm saying?
Could be a bad thing.
The violence is in your hands. So I could definitely see like him getting pissed. He bit a dude's ear off. He would definitely ear hole a dude in baseball. He would definitely be aiming at boys' heads in baseball.
Charge them out, saying? Bro. Charge
them out. Yeah, like, I fucking dare you to charge them out.
God damn.
He's upper decking you into the fucking press box, dog.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely happened.
Dude. I don't know. It was just something to think about. Like, you think about it, like, if they even put their mind frame to a different sport, they're gonna fuck.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, they're gonna blow it out the water, no matter what.
Absolutely, hell yeah. I love that. We could literally end that conversation right there.
Yeah.
But I want to bring up another person, and we could bring up a couple of these guys as well, because what I was thinking about when we talked about this was, excuse me. Oh, God damn, that was disgusting. What I was thinking about, have you seen Foot Locker had like this slam dunk contest back in like 1990, and it's Michael Irvin, Deion Sanders, Ken Griffey Jr. in like a dunk contest.
Yeah.
And so, like, I was thinking, especially because Ken Griffey Jr. just did a an interview with All the Smoke. Steven Jackson and Matt Barnes.
Yeah.
And he was talking about like basketball was like his one of his favorite sports besides baseball and everything. And he would have kept playing, but until he realized in like high school, like, yeah, I'm good. I got a chance to be like really fucking good at baseball, so I'm just gonna play baseball or whatever. So I would have been real interested to see how he would have done in basketball, because you know, him just being the freakish athlete that he was, you saw him like jumping up, robbing home runs and everything, yeah, like with ease. You know what I'm saying? His hand-eye coordination was off the charts. He could jump. You know what I'm saying? You saw him in that slam dunk competition. Like, he bounces one off the ground, off the backboard, yeah, and then he does a reverse dunk and shit. You know what I'm saying? And then just seeing him, you know, knowing him as a lefty, I feel like he would have had some touch as a shooter and everything. Like, I feel like, man, you know, he was just swagged out. You know, I think he would have been a good-ass basketball player as well. You know? Yeah,
I think about that one. That was a good one. You got to think with all these guys at some point, I say more than fucking 75% of these guys is like, all right, which sport do I want to go in? I have a chance to go and pro in all three of them. Which one am I going to go?
Which is crazy, right?
Yeah, it's fucking nuts, dude.
That's like, I mean, like Michael Vick. Michael Vick could have played baseball. A lot of people don't know that, but like Michael Vick was a pitcher. Like, he could have played baseball. He was pumping 90 from the left side. Like, that is a lucrative 90 from the left. You, especially back then, 90 from the left, you play for 10 years. You got a 10-year career, bro.
Hell yeah.
You got a 10-year career in the bag. 90 from the left with movement. Yeah. So
I think those dudes are more like, I say those dudes, but like Michael Vick seemed like, I mean, fucking look at him. He was fighting dogs and shit. I don't think baseball was his shit anyway. Like,
of course, that's why he ended up playing football. Yeah, that's why he ended up playing football. Obviously baseball isn't the most popular sport.
Yeah.
And the baseball literally went from being like
baseball, right?
What was that?
But the contracts are better in baseball, right? Or some shit like that.
Guaranteed contracts. It's the most lucrative sport out of like the American sports. You know what I'm saying? So it makes the most sense to go and play baseball.
Yeah, that's the thing. But it makes the most sense.
Yeah, it literally and figuratively makes the most sense to go and play baseball. But you know, it's not especially back then, it wasn't the coolest thing to go and play baseball. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, it was like viewed as kind of corny or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I mean, when I was coming up, there's a lot of black baseball players and everything. You know what I'm saying? When we were growing up, there's a bunch of them. But as you started to see basketball become more black, and like the best basketball players, like there were no more Larry Birds. There wasn't that many Larry Birds in the 90s. You know what I'm saying? It was like all black, and that shit was cooler. What was that?
It was more flashy. It was more flashy. With like, you know, like coincided with fucking the music. Like, you know, it was all fucking,
it was hip hop as fuck. Yeah.
Yeah. It all fucking clicked. Mm-hmm. Which makes us the best era.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. And then the same with football. Like, you saw all the running backs and everything. You know what I'm saying? The running backs, the receivers and everything. So, I mean, yeah. That's why I don't blame anybody, or I won't say I don't blame them, but I understand like athletes from that era, like going and choosing to play basketball and football over baseball.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And that was kind of like, that was after like the steroid shit. Like, well, it was like right kind of towards the end of that. And then like baseball got really high and then they just went.
Yeah. Yep. For sure. For sure, dog. So, dog, good shit. We smashed that hole. We knocked that hole out the park.
You can do that shit all fucking day. Like, you just think
absolutely
about all this shit. It's crazy.
Absolutely, that was good fucking shit. So the next question that we pondered, or I wouldn't even say this is a question, we decided to let's put together our super group. Okay. Our super group. So one rapper, two singers.
Yeah.
It can be a male singer. It could be a female rapper.
Yeah.
It could be a female R&B singer and a male R&B singer. It could be a male rapper, female R&B singer, a male rapper and male R&B singer, female R&B singer. We're going to put together our super group of what we would have liked to have seen way back when, what would have made sense to us. So, Money B, what you got? What do you got?
All right, let's hear this shit. Let's go, man, dude. Fuck. This was fucking hard. It was harder than I thought.
This was hard. It was hard, dog.
So are we going to go with our whole group at once, or are we going to go like, I go rapper, you go rapper? And then...
Nah, let's go with the whole group. I want to hear it all together. Fuck. Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. So I'm going to go with my R&B singer first. R&B singer is going to have to be Nate Dogg because he could sing.
Okay. All right. And I also want to hear like the reasons why. Like, what were you thinking
when picking these people? Dog. He's so fucking versatile. He could sing. He could like sing your panties off, and then he could hood just.
Yeah.
You know,
So I almost picked Nate Dogg. I almost picked Nate Dogg.
Yeah, it's so fucking close, dude. It was between him and T-Pain.
Oh shit! Okay. I didn't think about that one. Yeah.
All right, so Nate Dogg, and then just he had that West Coast style, but then you heard him on other people's shit because his style could go from coast to coast worldwide. Like his shit could go everywhere. He just wasn't in that one set thing.
Yeah, because you heard him on the West Coast shit. But then you also heard him on I Can't Deny It. I'm a fucking brother. On Fabulous's first single.
Yeah, and then 21 Questions and numerous other shit, dude. So.
Yep.
All right. So for my rapper, dude, fuck. And I just wanted to like mix it up just to fucking offset some of this shit. I'm going to go with Mace.
I thought Mace, about him too. I almost went with Mace too.
Mace at his fucking prime, dude. My it was between Mace and Cameron for me on this one. Like I wanted to just mix it the fuck up, you know?
I love it so far.
Mace at his fucking prime, dude. He was fucking humongous. He was huge. And he was spitting bars like you had to go back and think about. And then like for us, like you know, we were kind of younger, so it was shit that we hadn't even really heard of. Like, we had to go back, like, what the fuck does that mean? Even now, sometimes I go
back
and talk about back then, you know?
Yeah.
I knew it, but I didn't know what the fuck it was.
Yeah.
But then he had those melodic songs, too. Like, he kind of... So I think him and Nate would have been some shit, dude.
Hell yeah. And he had the whole maze... He had the whole flow, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He had the whole... The flow was just... You know, he could just ride, and then you could hear Nate Dogg just hopping in and taking that hoe from him, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly. So that was I mean, fuck, I wanted to go Cameron too, just because I fucking love the way
he definitely could have went, yeah.
But he's kind of the same thing. They have that fucking, I don't know what it is. They can do all of it, you know, either slow, fast, everything. They just fucking wreck it all. Either way. So I got Mason Nate Dogg right now, right?
Okay.
My woman, I went with a rapper. I went with the brat.
Okay. I fucks with it. Hell yeah.
Because she went hard, dude. She went so fucking hard.
I like that actually. Because you know what? Like she's like the hard one out of the group.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, she's the one coming out with that rugged shit, you know what I'm saying? Which would, like, catch everybody off guard.
Yeah, exactly.
I fucks with that.
See? Catching them off guard, dog. But then again, then she got nasty with some of her shit.
You
didn't expect it.
Boy, did she.
So, between that, it was the brat or Trina. Only because Trina's my fucking favorite.
Yeah.
But for this one, it was like the brat style would have went more with this shit.
I fucks with that. I like that a lot. And maybe we'll talk about this more on another episode when we talk about her at another time. But I had like a huge crush on the brat whenever she came out with that. What do you like?
I know
Tyrese. And I saw the video and I was like,
you saw her as like that? Like, fuck, where's that been hiding?
Like, oh my goodness, bro. Like, yo, the brat is fine as fuck, bro. Like, she foin. Like, foin. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, dog. That's a good-ass group right there.
That's a good group so far.
I like it.
So, for the bonus, we had a producer and then a name. I didn't come up with a name yet. I might, maybe by the end you finish yours, I might have a name for my group.
Okay. Okay. All right. Producer. What about producer though?
Man, dude. And now that I'm thinking about it, I probably went the wrong way with this. I was gonna say Little John, just to make it weird, but none of that would match. And I don't want to be cliche and say Timberland, you know?
Oh, motherfucker.
But then again, I didn't want to say Dre either. Like, you know, but I think maybe his style would match, you know, maybe there's Little John is just like too up there. Like, I don't think he would have made song like Mace and Nate and the Brad. Like, they're just too smooth with their shit.
I don't know, man, because Little John also made Lovers and Friends.
That's true. That's true.
You know what I'm saying? He has some like slow jammers. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's true.
I think he can dig in his bag for that shit.
That's true. That's true. But that's who I went with. But I don't know. Like, now that I'm thinking about it, I should have went with Bill. Somebody a little more seductive.
I don't know. I like it. I fuck with it, dog. Fuck with it. For real, for real. I fuck with it. So I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna follow your route. I'm gonna like list mine in the same order you did. So R&B wise, I'm gonna go with Usher.
Ooh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
I'm gonna go with Usher to start it off with. You know what I'm saying?
For some reason, I thought you were gonna lean to like KC.
I almost went KC because, all right. So my thinking into this thing, it was like, I had two different thoughts. I was thinking of this shit like a manager, kind of like, all right, who could I sell, or like who could I make the best music with? And so, or who would I like, you know, just like to hear with? And then the other thought I thought was like, what I felt would mesh the best. You know what I'm saying? So I was thinking KC because I was like, I want like an R&B nigga. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like just singing his fucking heart out. I'm talking early 90s R&B because like I've mentioned, like 90s R&B is my favorite shit. You know what I'm saying? Like that's my shit. So I almost went with KC, but I decided to go with Usher. You know what I'm saying? Because he fit more into the group that I was thinking about putting together. Yeah. So just to give an early hint to this shit, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to come with the sexy.
Okay.
Shit, you know what I'm saying? Raw seductive. You know what I'm saying? You know my style. Yeah, that's a good name. That's a good name. You can throw that in there. You can throw that in with yours. So I went with Usher. Now, the funny thing about Usher for me is I fucking hated Usher when he first came out. I fucking hated this guy, dog. I fucking hated this motherfucker, dude. Because when I was going to like babysitters and everything.
So when do you let me ask you, so when do you like, what was your first Usher song? Was it like his very first one? Are you old enough for that? Or
I don't remember, but I remember My Way. My Way is like when I really hated the motherfucker.
Oh, okay. That might have been like his second or third song, I think.
Yeah, yeah. I don't think it was his first one.
Yeah. I forget which one it was his first. If I hear it, I can't think of the name of it.
Yeah. But I hated him because I had a babysitter and I was like in love with her daughter. Like madly in love with her daughter. Picture young Dizzle Stacks, 4 or 5 years old. You know what I'm saying? And I go to my babysitter's house every day, and my babysitter had a daughter. She was like 16, 17 years old. And I'm just in love with this chocolate goddess. Mm-hmm. And I remember her, like, she liked Usher at the time. And I was like, fuck that nigga. He ain't got shit on me. You know what I'm saying? I got my own section of the house where I get to play. I got my own playroom. What that nigga got? He ain't got shit on a young Dizzle Stacks. So I could not stand Usher. You know what I'm saying? Because my crush, you know, I had a crush on Usher. You know what I'm saying? But I growing up, I couldn't deny, like, the nigga had jammers back then. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. The nigga had jammers. I fuck with Usher. And then just knowing that, you know what I'm saying, he came up with Diddy, you know what I'm saying? So he was kind of, he was kind of groomed around in the hip hop type scenario. I feel like this is manager Dizzle, you know, speaking now.
Yeah.
I feel like I could, you know, he would be fine with going on tour, you know what I'm saying, with a big hip hop star. You know what I'm saying? He wouldn't have no problems. We wouldn't have no issues. We wouldn't have to worry about a group splitting up because what I'm saying, somebody wasn't accustomed to this type of lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Usher could fuck with that. He could hang, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I had to fuck with Usher, you know what I'm saying? Throw Usher into the group, you know what I'm saying? Plus, he would keep it smooth, you know what I'm saying? He could talk about some hood shit in a smooth way, you know what I'm saying? And he's known for hopping on some rap tracks.
Yeah, he does, yeah.
And turning them hoes out, you know what I'm saying? True. So that's my first one. I had to go with Usher. He's the first part to my group. Now let's go hip hop. Okay.
All right.
My rapper. I'm choosing. You know what I'm saying? I'm going up north too. I'm going to New York too. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going fucking DMX, dog.
Oh, dude, see, and I wanted to. I was going to.
Fucking DMX, dog.
That's a good one, though.
Because DMX got that soul, but he's a roughneck nigga. He's a rough nigga. You know what I'm saying? And so you could just count on him to give you a good ass 16 that would like sentiment. It would relate to the ladies. You know what I'm saying? But it would also relate to the hood niggas as well. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And he's always gonna keep it real. He ain't gonna bullshit no verse for you. You know what I'm saying? Like he's always gonna keep that shit 100. And so so I had to go with DMX. I had to, you know what I'm saying? And
I was really close to doing that too. I was really close.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, and again, another thing that I took into consideration, like I just said with Usher, like what these bitches want, you know what I'm saying? He had his, you know, female songs and everything, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Right. You know, he intermingled in that, you know, that mixture. Female song? Oh, what these bitches want is absolutely his female song.
No, it's not. It's the one with fucking it's that other song, How It's Going Down. That's the female song.
You think so?
Yes, dude.
We gotta put up a poll. We gotta do a poll.
That's as slow as he gets, dog. That's his female song.
But listen, bitches love what these bitches want from a nigga.
That's true.
Bitches love that song, dog. I'm telling you, they love that fucking song. We're putting up a poll. We're putting up a poll.
Yeah.
Which is DMX's more song catered to the females? What do females like more?
Okay,
how's it going down?
Let's do it.
Or what these bitches want from a nigga?
Yeah,
that's what. Yeah, we're throwing that out there.
Yeah, we need to do more of that on our socials. We need to do more.
Yeah,
of that
we do. We definitely do. That's goal for 2021 is step up the socials game.
Yeah,
step
up that's a good resolution. That's a resolution. Yeah. Right.
Hell yeah. So that's what I'm going the second piece to. My super group, okay.
Usher and DMX.
My third piece is she's not as well known, but she was a beast back then,
all right,
way back when. And that's Maya, dog.
Oh, that's a good one. Forget about her, dude. Oh, she's so bad, too.
So bad.
That's gonna be a dark horse in that fucking tournament y'all are talking about.
Yep. So bad. And think about it, dog. Think about it. She has so many like hits and so many songs with hardcore rappers.
She's fucks with Trey a lot.
Trey and Zero. See, I just thought about like when I first made this pick, but I thought about for one, like she fuck with Zero and Trey. Like we talked about, just said, she fucked with Zero and Trey. But then I remembered the game, in which the game is always like fucking, he's always just he's always saying something about some kind of chicks or whatever, how he had this chick, how he had that chick or whatever. And which is like every now and then it's okay or whatever. But then sometimes it gets kind of tiring or whatever. It's like, all right, whatever, nigga, we get it. You know what I'm saying? But I remember in dreams when he was like, I had dreams of fucking the R&B bitch like Maya. When I saw that ass on the front of that King, read the article in the magazine, she loved gangsters, love nasty things. So I'm in the glass house having nasty dreams. Yep. And I was like, oh, yo, he's like, he's right. Like, yo, Maya, she gets down like that. You know what I'm saying? And so that's why I was like, oh, when I thought about it again now, like putting this group together, I was like, oh, she fits in perfect to this because, you know what I'm saying? We got Usher with the smoothness, you know what I'm saying? And she can come and bring that soft, angelic R&B smoothness. But then we also got DMX with the roughneck shit, and she gets right into that mix as well. She fits right into there. You know what I'm saying? So I fuck with Maya, bro. She was so bad, dog. Oh my God, I loved her back then. My love is like, whoa, nigga. My love is like, whoa. I used to watch that shit on repeat on Yahoo Music video channel on the internet. Oh my gosh.
Hell yes. I'm gonna watch that later.
My nigga. I fuck with Maya the long way.
The strong way.
But she would just fit perfect into this group, you know what I'm saying, of just rawness and smoothness, you know what I'm saying. And good for that too. What was that?
That's a good name too.
Rawness and smoothness, that's okay. But I think the better name of it would be that gutter butter. That gutter butter, because that's what you're getting. You're getting that gutter butter. And just imagine like DMX like hopping on the beginning of the track, or just like imagine him like just in an interview. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? With the gutter butter. You know what I'm saying? You get the gutter coming from me, and you got my nigga Usher coming through with the butter, smooth as butter. You know what I'm saying? And you intermingle, got my. You know what I'm saying? The gutter butter, put it together. That gutter butter. You know what I'm saying? I had that gutter butter. And then for the producer, you know, I had to put my favorite producer all time, Timbaland.
That could go though, because he can fucking, he'll cook up some shit.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. I had to. I mean, you said earlier, I mean, I guess that is like an obvious choice.
Yeah,
but I had to throw him in there. I guess what would be, I would say if I had to choose somebody other than Timbaland, I would say Just Blaze. Just Blaze, maybe. Or maybe, no. Let's take it down south. Polo to Don.
Ooh, that'd be a good one.
Polo to Don.
That'd be
I'm going to say Polo to Don.
Yeah, that'd be a real good one.
Yeah, I would say that would be good. I would love, because Polo to Don made he made beats that sounded Southern, but then he also made beats that you would have known came from him. You know what I'm saying? And so I fucked with Polo to Don.
Yeah.
I would love to hear some more shit from him actually. Mm-hmm. I want to find out what the fuck is going on with him, because he was good musically. I fuck with Polo the Don. But yeah, that would be my group, dog.
That's a good one.
Usher, Maya, and DMX, gutter butter. You know what I'm saying? Produced by Polo the Don. That album coming to a worldwide tour. You know what I'm saying? Just hitting up city to city. You know what I'm saying? You getting the best of everything, that gutter butter. You know what I'm saying? And you know, You could find them, you know, backstage, just, you know, blowing doty, you know what I'm saying? Having a good ass time. None of them not worried about nothing. You know what I'm saying? Just having a good ass time and keeping them moving to the next city.
Usher and DMX are only worried about child support. That's it.
You know what I'm saying? That's it. You know?
So. Hey, I got Mace, Nate Dogg and the Brat. I'm gonna go Raw Seductive with my name, but
I like that.
But the Raw's not coming from Mace or Nate Dogg. It's coming from the Brat.
The Brat. The Brat. Absolutely.
That's different.
Absolutely. Dude. And the seductiveness is coming from all of them.
All of them.
It can come from either one of them. It could come from Nate.
The Brat would bring in some broads for him too, you know, like.
Ooh, yep. Yep.
So.
I fucking like that. Yeah, those are two good ass groups.
I'm here with the Woadies. What fucking groups would these motherfuckers come up with?
Yeah.
You got some Wild Boys and girls on that shit. Like,
yeah. See, so I almost, well, no, my initial one that I came up with, well, I won't say the group, but what I was going to first formulate my group off of was off of your most hated person, and that's Missy Elliott. Missy Elliott, dog, because you literally can't go wrong.
Nah,
you can't go wrong because she does it all, dog.
Fucking bitch.
She does it all, man.
Let's not start off the year this way, man.
I almost started it off with Missy Elliott, dog.
I thought you were gonna go fucking. What did I say earlier? Who the fuck did I say? Fuck, I forgot. Oh, Casey. I thought you were gonna go Casey.
Casey.
You were gonna go Missy Elliott, and I thought for sure you were gonna go with Timberland.
Yeah.
That's why I didn't really want to go with
Timberland. You know me, because I thought about Casey, and like I said, Missy Elliott was my first pick.
That gonna be your woman or your rapper? So DMX was always
because she could go either way. I was thinking about going Missy Elliott, another chick, and then just having another dude. Didn't know if I could have went. I could have went Missy Elliott and like Lil Kim, and then like an R&B singer mixed with both of them.
That shit would have went wild.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what I thought you were going with this year.
Like I thought of a couple different combinations because Missy Elliott is so versatile, dog. She could do it all, bro. She could freak anything. You know what I'm saying? I thought about going like Missy Elliott and Cameron. You know what I'm saying? That shit would be crazy.
That would be kind of dope.
Would be crazy, dog.
Yeah.
Just the styles combined and everything. You know what I'm saying? That shit would have been wild.
Yeah.
But yeah, I thought of you know, just bringing it back. I wanted to have a smoothness and a roughness. You know what I'm saying? Massaged together.
But see, I was trying to just bring everything together. Like I even thought he's still big now, but big as fuck now. But Kanye, like his beats back then.
Yeah.
Like if you would have heard, like I don't think Nate Dogg was ever on any of his shit, was he?
Nah, not that I can think of, not that I can remember.
Yeah, but like shit like that, and then so that's why I was like, well, Lil Jon, like I wanted to bring like somebody from the South, East, West, like all this shit together, just because they were so fucking dope in their areas. Yeah. When you bring them all together, fuck.
I feel that too. Yeah. I feel that. I was thinking about doing. I mean, Ye would have been easy. Wheezy would have been easy, but I wanted to stay away from people that are still like active today.
Yeah. Kind of the same shit.
You know what I'm saying?
I didn't think about Wheezy. I didn't think about fucking like Manny Fresh's beats. I didn't even think
about that. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Oh damn, I didn't think about Manny. I might want to throw Manny on my shit, dog.
We might have to have this could be like a continuation. Like whenever we have a guest, let's hear their fucking, this could be one of them questions.
Your super group, dog.
Yeah,
you're super good. All right, you know, I've been wanting to do this for a while. It just came up to me. All right, what if you could go on a ski trip? If you could go on a ski trip with anybody, this is something I've been thinking about, and I haven't even came up with my answer yet. If you could go on a ski trip with anybody in history, who would you go on your ski trip with?
Now, is it just one person, or are we going to group?
It's just one person.
One person.
You know what? Ponder on that.
Yeah.
We'll answer. We'll put our answers at the top of the show next week.
Yeah. Okay.
Let's do that. Let's do that. But that's the question I've been wanting to answer every guest that's come on here. And I always forget. You know what I'm saying? All right. So think about that. At the top of the show next week, we'll both answer that. If we could go on a ski trip, and remember, and this is all negative side effects aside. Like, there's no side effects. There's no, you know what I'm saying? It's all positives.
Okay.
It's all good shit.
There's no rest, none of this shit.
I'm just saying, yeah, you're going to get in some fights. You're going to get in some fights. Fuck that. You're going to get in some fights. I'm just saying you don't get addicted. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't lead to anything else.
Ain't nobody worried about none of that shit.
Yeah. I'm saying there. You know what I'm saying?
You're going for a weekend ski trip.
That's it. It happens. You forget about it, or everybody forgets about
it. Where's the ski trip taking place? Vegas or some shit like that?
The place of your dreams, my friend. Oh, yeah. The place of your dreams.
Yes.
So yeah, ponder on that, and yeah, we'll get to y'all next week on that. But
I already got my answer. I got my answer down to the year. But go ahead.
Okay. Okay. I'm excited, and I'm sure the Woodies are now too. But we're gonna leave y'all on a cliffhanger. Y'all don't get to hear that until next episode. Sorry, Woodies. Because you know what. It's time. I'm sorry to say it, Woodies, but it's closing time. It's closing time.
Closing time. One last shot of liquid crack. Your fix is coming to an end. Closing time. Say goodbye to diesel stacks and money because we're out this big.
Money B, before we get out of here, man, what do you got for the Woodies?
Oh man, thanks for all last year. You know, I don't know if you've been able to check the stats or any of that shit like you did the last time, but I mean, I'm sure we fucking had some good episodes. Let's just keep growing and growing, and let's just keep it fucking moving. Everybody have a fucking good New Year's, and stick to our resolutions if y'all have them. If not, you know, just fucking get better at whatever you want. That's it, though.
I like that. Get better at whatever you want. That's
get better at whatever you fucking feel like you need to get better at.
Especially after 2020. 2020 was a tough year for a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? And that's some good-ass advice to get. You know what I'm saying? Just get better at whatever you want.
Yeah, everybody can improve at something, no matter what it is. So whatever it may be, whether it be diet, whether it be fucking financial, you know, education, anything, whatever it is, just fucking
drinking.
Drinking.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah. I fuck with that. I like that a lot, actually. We used to taking it back to just, I mean, boring, but taking it back to athletics. Like, our motto used to be, like, get better every day.
Yep.
So I fuck with that a lot. I like that. Well, my end, man, just thank y'all. Thank y'all a lot for rocking with us again. Let's, you know, we're starting off 2021. We're trying to continue to keep growing. My goal for this year is at least, and this is averaging 50,000 listeners. That's my goal by the end of the year. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So share this with all of your friends. You know what I'm saying? Especially the ones that you know that would fuck with this shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Share this. Just let them know about it. Teach them how. That's one thing that I've realized is that, like, a lot of people don't know how to listen to podcasts.
Yeah, it's fucking nuts.
Yeah, I never realized that. So, I mean, you know, put that on us. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But yeah, teach them, show them how to listen to podcasts and shit. Yeah, but we're just trying to grow this thing. We appreciate y'all, man, because the loyal ones who listen, they fuck with us, and I fuck with y'all the long way, like heavily.
We fucks.
Together. Yeah. Let us gingerly touch our tips. We literally appreciate it, man, because we get to hop on here each week and bullshit and talk about, you know, shit that we love, and y'all fuck with us for that. And I'm overly appreciative of that. And we're just gonna continue to try and keep putting smiles on people's faces. If anything Bread Baby related, you know what I'm saying, if you're fucking with that, I appreciate you. If you want to be a part of the team, holla at me. You know what I'm saying? Y'all already know the apps, Dizzle Stacks 10K. That's 1X on Stacks, Dizzle Stacks 10K on Instagram and Twitter. Holla at me, or just hit up Bread Baby. You know what I'm saying? Bread Baby Gang, Bread Baby ENT. You know, find us on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all that. Holla at me if you want to come be a part of the team. We're always looking for people to help us push this shit to the next level, and we understand that it's going to take a team. Like, it's definitely not just going to be me. You know what I'm saying? We're trying to do big things. You know what I'm saying? And if you want to be a part of something huge, which we're going to be, fuck with us. You know what I'm saying? So I appreciate y'all. Keep listening to Chocolate Covered Frog Legs. Let me tell you why you're wrong. And keep watching Whose Bar Is It Anyways, man. That's definitely, and especially doing big things as well. Because that shit's growing. You know, yeah. Whose Bar is growing? Whose Bar is growing pretty well. And I'm proud of that. Shout out to Dub and Lou. Chocolate Covered Frog Legs is growing as well. Shout out to DJ Morgan. You know what I'm saying? Man. That's about it, man. I just appreciate y'all. Let's fuck this year up. Let's fuck 2021 up and make it our bitch. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
It was even kind of weird. Whenever Dub filled in, I was like, I gotta catch up on my own shit. And listening to it, I was like, fuck, man. Like, now I know what people, you know, like Peanut and other people say. Like, I was out there with it. Yeah. Because yeah. I'm literally talking to the mate, because I'm so used to this shit. Like, I was literally talking to my fucking, in my truck. I was literally talking to the radio. I was like, no, that was so-and-so said that, you know? And
then
I did go back and listen to all the Tupac shit. Like, when you do go back to the fuck. And one of the things, I guess we got another one we probably have to hit up, is like album. You know, we talked about, you know, album.
Yeah, we got to get back to album. We got to do another albums episode.
That seven, that Illuminati 7-Day Theory album, dude, that bitch plays straight through.
Hell yeah. And that's the beauty of the show, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, y'all know what it is. And first time listeners, we thank y'all for being here. You know what I'm saying? If you were referred to from a Wodey, you know what I'm saying? Welcome to Wodey here. You know what I'm saying? So around this time, you know, we take this closing time shot. Money B, you ready?
Yes, sir. What's that boy up on?
Come on, that maker.
Come on, that maker.
Cranberry Marcus. Nah, just straight makers, baby. Just straight makers. You know what I'm saying? What you on?
I'm on that screwball, man. That peanut butter.
Is that the peanut butter shit?
Yeah, pretty good. Okay,
yeah, hell yeah.
Shout out to EJ, right?
EJ, yeah. I need to fuck with that shit.
Yeah.
Good shit. All right. Money B, you ready?
Yes, sir.
To you, my friend.
Sir.
To the year 2021, to the Wodeys, and to the Way Back When podcast. We appreciate all of you. Cheers, my friend. Wodeys, thank you for joining us for another episode of the Way Back When podcast, a reflection upon the golden era, our golden era. We'll holler at y'all next week. Deuces.
Peace.
I know who I want to take me back. I know who I want to take me back. I know who I
want to take me back, way back when. I know who I want to take me back. I know who I want to take me back. I know who I want to take me back, way back when.